Contest prep series. Okay, well, I'm umpteen weeks out. Shows keep getting scheduled and then rescheduled and then changed locations. So as of the moment, I just found out my next show has been moved out another week. So I'm 7 weeks out now, I don't know. And then Masters Nationals is like 3 days after the show. So waiting to hear from my coach on whether or not he thinks that's a grand idea to do these back to back. But I'm gonna take you through kind of some things for the week, my workouts, my foods, etc. And this will be the 7 week out video series. Good morning. Before I go train clients, this is a very huge shaker cup, but I get myself ready. BCAAs and EAAs, just a combo. And I sip on this while I'm training clients before my first meal, which is around between 7 and 7:30. And right now it's about 5:50 in the morning and I'm headed out. Again, cardio is my least favorite thing to do in prep. I rather diet. but I actually feel a ton better when I do it. It just takes me forever to get going. You know, I don't know. It's like, I don't know if I'm fucking old or what the deal is, but your girl don't like to do cardio. I procrastinate that shit. And I take my dog for a walk to kind of like motivate myself to continue the momentum of cardio. I take Roger, he's running around somewhere, for a little walk for about 10 minutes. And then if I'm feeling up for it, I will usually sprint the orchard. So I'm in one of the aisles of the orchard. My dog, when he takes a shit, he scrapes it like a cat, like he tries to cover it. I don't know, it's weird. But I will sprint the orchards when they're swept and there aren't a bunch of almonds on the ground because I don't want to roll an ankle. And then I will turn and then I will walk halfway through another aisle. And then I will usually do that for my HIIT cardio for about 20 minutes. But there are almonds all over the ground right now. I called my dad yesterday because my Freddy garage, which I'll show you here in just a second, and I call it the Freddy Krueger garage because it's mildly terrifying. It looks like Freddy Krueger possibly and Jason Voorhees live in there and plot their evil and their death-defying shit. And I just woke up from a nap. It's covered in black widows and spiders and they've been shaking almonds and dust and the fires. So it's been disgusting to say the least. And my pops came over yesterday, took a broom and a leaf blower and it's mo better now. So I'm not going to get attacked by all the black widows that live out here on this road. Yeah, I'm going to do some, treadmill sprints.
Right. I told you it was mildly terrifying. This is, the Freddy garage. And there was a snake in here the other day. But it's much cleaner than it was. It's kind of gross, but guess what? It does the job.
Okay, well, I didn't really tell you guys how much cardio I'm doing right now. I'm 6 weeks out, I guess, like, I think. everyone's like, oh my God, aren't you getting so upset? Your shows keep getting rescheduled and, you know, show dates have been changed here and there. And it, honestly, not really. Like, yeah, I'm a little frustrated. I kind of just want to like plan it and like do the damn thing. But I'm of the mindset of this is honestly like really like how my lifestyle has been for the last, consistently more than anything, last 3 years. I took a break from bodybuilding for about 4 years prior to that and was doing powerlifting and got really into yoga certification and my studio. So I was still training, but I wasn't competing because I had competed for probably 4 years prior to that. So just back in the swing of things, and this is just how, like, this is kind of just how I eat.
Granted, in the off season, when I'm not in an actual cut, I'm a lot more lackadaisical with my food choices. So right now it's kind of Groundhog Day with my food choices, which hopefully I'll show you some point later in the week with my meals and whatnot. Right now, my cardio is 3 days of HIIT training, high intensity interval training, which I absolutely do not like because it's hard and it should be hard, which I'm about to do right now. And it's 25 minutes and I can pick and choose kind of what I want to do. I got a brand new Garmin Venue, which was sole purpose for me is to track my heart rate. I want to make sure that I'm staying within a 160 to 170 heart rate zone for my HIIT training, which is very hard to do. So this will at least give me a more accurate picture of how hard I'm pushing myself. And then the other days I have also, so 3 days of HIIT and 3 days of steady state. So 6 days a week of cardio. And my steady state right now is just 30 minutes. And typically I will do a high incline walk or I will just do a steady state jog through the orchards. And I also will bust out my weighted vest. It's about 40 pounds. If I'm feeling like I need to like walk off some demons, some stress, I'll slap that bitch on, I'll get on here, and I'm literally like covered by the time I'm done in sweat. So that's my cardio right now. I also, at this point, will make sure that I get 10,000 steps per day. Tomorrow is an off day for me at the studio, so I'm not really walking around a whole lot. I'll be home working on my competitors' programs and my nutrition coaching programs. So I will be sitting for probably 6 hours, not straight, but like throughout the day, so I won't get a whole lot of movement. I will make sure to go for 10-minute walks with my dogs, and then I will not go to bed until I hit 10,000 steps. And that's because my average is generally about 6 to 7. When I'm in prep, I just find that that extra little bit of activity helps me keep lean without drilling down lots of, without being on the treadmill for like an hour. I can take some leisure walks here and there, but hit that 10K and stay on track with my goals. All right, so today is leg day. And this season of prep, actually, all seasons of prep, I'm trying to build my quads. I know that going into this national show, that for symmetry purposes, which is what bodybuilding is all about, is that my quads are my handicap and they are small and tiny and little, whittle, whittle, whittle. And so I'm trying to constantly build them. If anything, I know that that will be the one thing, well, one of a couple things that will be what holds me back from winning when I go to this national show. So that being said, leg day is not my favorite. I struggle a little bit. I'm here at my gym. This is my studio here where all the fun things happen for training all the ladies. So I'm going to be working on really working on activations for quads. So even though I need to go heavy for quads, I definitely am hamstring and glute dominant. I think that was just from many years of bikini training before I got back into figure again. Yeah. Glutes are just fun to train. Quads burn like in a barfalicious way. So I'm going to work on activations. I'm gonna do a lot lighter weight this week. I wanna feel my muscles. I feel like my last two workouts, I've been grinding out heavy front squats and things and not very sore, which is not a huge indicator of anything, but I just wanna make sure that I'm like feeling everything. So we're gonna hit some leg extensions right back here, front squats and some sissy squats, and then I'm gonna see how I feel. So I'll get a little bit of footage. It's a beautiful life. Yeah. It's Friday. And I have a full morning of clients Yeah, it's 5 a.m. My weight has not dropped this week. It's, in fact, been all over the place. I think I've been just, like, retaining water. And I log everything, which I'll show you guys in just a second. But let's see what the scale says. I think it's probably going to be, based off of my patterns, 151, 151.2, something like that.
What's wrong? It's even more.
Starting to come more alive now. Okay, but anyways, it'll look cute, I promise. Okay, so every morning I get up and sit here in my vanity, put my face on, become human, and then I also have a notepad on my vanity. Every morning I log my AM weight, my PM weight, and any notes related to the day, the day's workout, the cardio, how I'm feeling, etc. I started logging a lot about my day in and day outs of prep in 2018, when I kind of got back into it, just as something for me to reference back to for future preps, for me to look back, see what I did different, what worked, what didn't work. And just honestly, like, trends in my weight. So I knew as the weeks approach kind of where I should be every prep. If I'm, like, behind and if I need to kind of, like, ramp things up. Obviously, prep to prep is a little different. Hoping that you put on some muscle and, you know, the scale is going to look a little bit different. And I probably should be doing measurements as well, but I fucking suck at that and I hate doing it, so I don't do it. All right, I'm going to give you a peek at my journal. This is my very non-technical journal. This is how I log my shit. I don't like doing things digitally because I will forget that it's there. So I think there's, like, a few days I skipped in here, but down to, like, how much sleep, what cardio I did for the day, my AM and PM weights. As you can see, it fluctuates obviously in the evening with food volume, water, poop, water retention, all the things. So this week I had a refeed on, no, this is actually not this week. This was the prior week. My refeed was on a leg day. And then usually my weight kind of spikes up somewhere in there, and it did. Yeah, and that's it. Pretty boring. Ooh, all right. So today I posed my competitors. So I'm a coach. So I coach other women to compete. Doing my cardio. Today was a hamstring day for me. Sadly, I didn't get any video footage of that because it was a great killer workout with me and my training partners. But my clients are 4 weeks out right now from the Tahoe show, Center Podium's Tahoe show. So this next little bit of footage, I'm gonna sneak in some of their posing practice. So they're about, like I said, 4 weeks out. So we've been posing every Saturday. Posing is a huge component of competition. I didn't take it quite as seriously as I should have earlier in my competition days. I was just like, oh, okay, you know, met with our coach for evaluations and a little bit of posing, but I didn't really practice on my own. So I was like, oh, what's the big deal? It's huge. So you'll see a few girls, obviously different shapes, different looks. Some of them are a little more on schedule than others. Their diets are all varying based on where they're at. I have some bikini girls, a wellness competitor. I actually have two, but one of them wasn't there today. And then some figure girls. So check it out. And face the judges. About 6.5 weeks out here. I just got done doing fasted cardio, not because fasted cardio is magical, but because I just wanted to get it done before breakfast and I was up early. So just getting a video in to do some check-in photos for my coach. I got cupped this week, so hence the octopus pepperoni marks. And then I just take screenshots from that business, send it in, and I get orders.